On Hulu, I watched, and I'm going to keep this short because it sucks, Staying Alive from 1983. I shit you not. Written and directed by Sylvester Stallone. The continuing adventures of Tony Manero in it. Tony Manero, played by John Travolta. His character from Saturday Night Fever. You know, what happens when you have a hit, but the music that inspired it is gone, is out of vogue? What do you do? Oh, well, you come on. I must have stepped in something rank. What am I smelling? Gee, what? So what do you do? Well, you go into 1983 and you say, hey, who's a director at this period of time that has made financially successful sequels? Sylvester Stallone. So you get him to helm your dance movie. And you sub out disco for what can best be described as, modern dance. You know the conceptualized dancing you see they used to do at the Oscars. I think they got rid of it. But you call it a Broadway show, so he wants to be on Broadway, right? And you got the guy who killed RoboCop. He's there. He's a choreographer. Has like zero lines. Just taps people on the shoulder, showing that they're done cutting people from the dance troupe. And they're putting on these musicals. But would you call it a musical if there's no singing? I mean, it's almost like something from Showgirls. Like, they have this conceptualized dance with a bunch of, like, tattered clothing, and they're in hell, I guess, right? So, Tony's dating this chick. They're hooking up, and you may or may not recognize her, because she looked quite a bit skinnier in Dirty Dancing. She was Penny from Dirty Dancing. A great movie, which this is not. But, so we know she's a dancer. I don't remember the character's name, we're just gonna call her Penny. So he's hooking up with Penny, and he goes and sees one of her performances where she's a background dancer on a big Broadway musical, and he gets like enamored with the star, and he's hitting on her, and there's really nothing to it. He just kind of mopes around by her room, and he's like, hey, so, I'm gonna see you again, right? And she's like, okay, whatever. And then they're hooking up, and then he's got the side chick, Penny, and she's hooking up with somebody else, and he is like jealous now. Oh, but his girl now, the star, she's with the director of the musical. Oh, and the guy that Penny's with now in their band, Frank Stallone. Yeah, Norm MacDonald's Frank Stallone, always Frank Stallone. So, here's the problem. Not only is the dancing awful, it's a whole lot of jumping. It's a whole lot of, we're jumping. This is dance. I'm embarrassed to do this. I'm walking around with a 6-foot pole in front of my chest. But that's the dancing in this movie. And the music is even worse. The songs are dreadful. I've said that Saturday Night Fever has probably the best soundtrack of the 70s. We're looking at movies that have contemporary music in them, not, oh hey, we know this is a hit 10 years later, yeah, we're gonna put a whole lot of hits in our movie. What does this have? Filth. I mean, I love 80s music. Let's not use love. I love the best 80s music. This is the worst example of 80s music you can think of. And that's all your movie is. Shallow, just exposition bombs. Hey, did I get the part? Oh, hey, I got the part. Oh, hey, now you're with this guy. Well, what are you gonna do, Tony? Now you have to go dance. They have these lyrics like, fire, dance. It's like, what? This is garbage. At one point, John Travolta bumps into Sylvester Stallone on the street just so we can have a director cameo. Aside from Homeland, which is pretty recent, this was, for a while there, the only written and directed by Stallone movie in which he's not in it, let alone the star. And at the end, Tony's dancing with the his kind of tensioned flame there, British girl he was into, that's now hooking up with the director and whoever else. And she's a kept woman, basically. And they're having a bit of a fight while they're dancing. And then he goes off book, makes her jump really high to catch up with him, and everybody thinks it's spectacular. This movie is boring as all hell. I really can't think of anything particularly redeeming. Even the way the dances are shot. 1983, okay? Flashdance. 10 times better. In every aspect. Better music, better acting, better story, better choreography, better direction, better cinematography. This is just crap. Staying Alive is anything but. Oh, and at the end of the movie, it's like, hey, you're a star now. What are you gonna do? Now I need to strut. Which I remember Bart Simpson doing this. He's like, it's time to strut. Then he heads out and starts walking like at the beginning of Saturday Night Fever. And that's what they did here. I'm thinking, okay, so Saturday Night, God, this is Staying Alive. Staying Alive, 1 out of 4 stars.